whenever I'm going somewhere, I kind of have to plan it out ahead before, because it takes me a while to jump in my truck. But I just want to show you guys, you know, the process of me just getting around. And so we're going to... This is my truck. I love it. Definitely, you get along, get around it like that. When my accident first happened, they're like, I just couldn't get around. I can't see myself driving a van. And I'm like, I'm not that old yet, so. Yeah, man, it's cold out. And when it's snowing like this or rain, you know, you really gotta, like, hurry and, because I've sat out here and got wet before. It's like, you know, and it's cold here in Utah. So, but at least the rest of the average. I always joke around, I say, we put people on the moon. You think they can speed this stuff up a little bit? Especially when it's raining, but again, I'm just grateful to have it. And then, so this does my seat. This gets my seat out. And this one, I have to get the crane. Under there, and try to speed it up a little bit with the time. So I'll usually use two hands, like to do this one, and then this one. It's got a few different buttons, and when it's cold, it like sometimes it don't work, and it makes it like, oh man, you're sitting there hitting the button and it don't work. It's like some electrical or something. It's kind of really frustrating, you know, kind of how much we depend on it. And, but, you know, it's just so nice to have. You know, when my accident first happened, like, I was like, everyone deserves their independence. Deserves to be able to kind of do things for yourself. I mean, especially us in a wheelchair, we kind of want to do it ourselves. We just have other people do it. And even when, you know, the electrical is doing that, or, you know, whatever, that you can really stop still and just be grateful you have it. Because there was a time there when I didn't have anything. I was so depressed, like, you know, I had to depend on people. And It was the worst, so, you know, all of these things, and sometimes, you know, we take it for granted, just because we're so used to doing them every day, that, you know, I think, I'm a little bit slower, so I watch people, and they're just always in a hurry, and it makes you appreciate, you know, time. But, yeah, hopefully this will go up. Thank you. see how I drive as well, which is really cool. So nice, but see if we can get the same thing out. Yeah. I always joke around, I traded my motorcycle in for a wheelchair. I figured it would be a little safer. No, but it's pretty easy. After I get in, get hooked up, I just back for gas. It looks like a gear shifter. And it's back for gas and then forward for brakes. And it's hooked down there into the pedals. So you know you can still drive up with the other lights, but and then for turning, because you know your hands, they got these suicide knobs, and the other one's getting fixed. But on this thing, you could—it's got buttons on it, and you could flick it, and it'll do the blinker one side. Flick it, and it'll do the blinker on the other side. It does that, and my windshield wipe. That way, it's like when you're in a wheelchair, you don't want to, you know, use it. Kind of makes it easy, so you don't gotta reach for this and reach for that. And yeah, it's so nice to have. You know, and pretty simple. I had a car once, and the car, it was hard. And this one, after my accident, started driving. I got a car, and it was down for gas and in for brake, a little neon. And I remember I was nervous after like a year or 2 years of being in a hospital. I was like, oh man, I'm gonna be driving again. And it's been 16 years now. But you know when the light turns yellow and you're like, you don't know whether to stop or go? Well, I went like on the other side and stopped, like I thought I was slowing down. But this, you can't really mistake it. Like it's just back for gas and then forward for brake. And this pedal is so nice, man. Like, it's got me to the gym like so many times. You know, when depended on my other people. And yeah, it's super, super nice. I had a call on that, but yeah, and I think in life, like I said, we forget how easy it is to do that. So when I go to the gym, it's like a workout to go to the gym. You know, it takes me all of this energy, like all this extra effort that just to get to the gym, and I do it, you know, to work out, because like I see how important our health is. Number one, like you got to take care of our bodies. You know, it's important to stay healthy, drink water. I'm kind of dehydrated right now, but I just feel so blessed. Got to cruise up to Salt Lake, pick up my meals from 1% Fitness, and eat healthy, feel great, man. Got some good. I think diet has probably been number one, like, on why I've been able to accomplish so much and why I've been, like, able to do all these cool things. It's because it's like our bodies, we're putting this stuff into our bodies, and, you know, it's nourishing. But it's like an apple when you eat an apple, you become an apple. So it's important that we get all those nutrients and vitamins and check our levels all the time. Yeah, I feel blessed. And also in the snow, sometimes it'll be pouring rain and the windshield wipers. And by the time I get back home, my wheelchair will be like soaked, like the back of it. And so I got to, it's all these little things, I guess. On top of it, it's not the wheelchair, it's not a problem, it's just like everything around it. But there's always a silver lining in that. So, but thanks for watching, and I appreciate. appreciate you guys looking into my truck. Oh, look, it's almost 4:14. That's ironic. So my birthday is 4:14, and my racing number, oh, there it is. My racing number was 4:14. Man, that couldn't happen any better. That is so cool. So that number means something. I'm glad to have you guys check it out. And yeah, get in my truck. Wear your seatbelt for sure. And yeah, but here in Utah, we've got beautiful mountains. Head up to the point of the mountain and go check out the weather and hang out, do some paragliding. You guys, come on out, man. Utah, really, you're missing. Like, Utah is a beautiful place. We'd love to have you come out and learn how to fly. And yeah, it's fun out there. It's heaven's playground. So, thanks again for watching, you guys.